Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by... Do you all remember what you had learned in the previous two classes of this module? You learned about the standard toolbar. Which all options can you have in the standard toolbar? In the standard toolbar, you can keep all those options of the menu bar that you use the most and can then use them directly. Can you tell how you will type within a blank slide? Using the text tool, you can type within a blank slide. How will you insert a new slide and in how many ways can you insert a new slide? You can insert a new slide in two ways. In the first method, you need to right-click with your mouse or touchpad in the slide pane and select the new slide option there. Your new slide will get inserted. In the second method, you need to click on the insert menu and select the new slide option to get a new slide inserted. In order to make 5 copies of an image in one go, what would you need to do? In order to make 5 copies at one go of any image, you will use the duplicate option. Now, all of you switch on your computers and using any method already taught to you, open the Impress file. Let us now begin today's class. In today's class, you will learn about the options of the file menu like wizard, send, property, templates, printer settings, and preview in web browser, etc. Next, all of you insert 3 slides and type out the paragraph being shown to you in the first slide. In the second slide, insert a picture, and in the last slide, from the shapes, insert any shape. If you like, you can do some formatting also on these slides like outline color, fill color, and can even change the line size and line width. With the help of this video, we are now going to insert new slides in our Impress file and also do different work in them. So to get a new slide, take your cursor to the slide pane, right click on it and then select the new slide. If you want to change it to a blank slide, go to the layouts and select the blank layout. So your slide becomes blank. Now, if you want to insert a picture in this, go to insert option and go to select the picture option and from file, select the from file option from there. It opens the location where your pictures can be. So you can select the picture's location and let's select the penguin's picture. Click on open and you will see that the penguin's picture gets inserted in your new slide. Next, we want another new slide. So right click on the slide, click on new slide, and you will see now a normal slide opens. A blank slide opens. The third slide is a blank slide. Now we want to insert a shape. So go to the toolbar, the drawing toolbar, and from there, pick any shape that you like. Let's pick this shape. And then you can come back to the slide and then drag and get that shape on the slide. If you want to do some formatting on this, you need to select this picture that you have just inserted by clicking on it. And go to the line and filling toolbar. Let's first change the outline. Let's select an outline. You can increase the width of the outline by clicking here, and you can also change the color of the outline from here. So we have done that, and you can enter color inside the drawing. So we have selected bitmap. If you click on the down arrow here, you can see many options of the bitmap which get colored in your slide. So select one. So this way we have been able to select, get three new slides and do different kinds of work on our slides. Let us now begin to learn about all those options which you had not learned about in the basic module of Impress. Let us first learn about the wizard option. Using the wizard option, you can set up the formats for letters, facts, etc. Let us now take the help of this video to understand how you can use the wizard option. With the help of this video, let us now see how we can make use of the wizard option in our Impress file. To use that, go to the file menu, select the wizards option, and there are various options here: letter, fax, presentation. Let's select letter. As soon as you select letter, a box opens which shows you what type of letter you want. So is it a business letter or a formal personal letter or a personal letter? So let's select a formal personal letter. Then you select the page design, what type of design you want to apply. You can select one of those designs. Click on next. Here you can select the typical letter format for the country. For instance, you want to send to Germany or in English, USA. Then you can look for the return address in envelope window, whether it should be there or not. You can select that. You can select the subject line, what kind of subject line you want. The salutation, like saying hello. Similarly, you have complimentary clause, where you can select options. You can also have a footer. The complimentary clause can be sincerely, best regards, cheers. So you can select what you like and then click on the next. Once you go to the next option, it shows you specify the sender and the recipient information. So you can either use the data from already existing, or you can type in a new sender's address, your address, the sender's address. And you can also use an existing recipient's address, or use the address database from mail merge. So you can use these options. Go to next. Then in the footer, you can type whatever text you want to show as a footer. For instance, we are saying here computer shiksha as a footer. Click on next, and it says please specify the last settings, what type of template name, create a letter from this template, or make manual changes in this letter template. So we've selected manual changes, and if the file is already existing, we can just say no to it and click on open copy from the next options, so that you can see the type of letter which you are preparing, the type of the template for the letter. This is the letter wizard that you have prepared, which you can use later in your file whenever you want to send a letter. Similarly, so you can see all that we had typed: computer shiksha, the date is there, the address is there, the greeting is there. You can close this, come back to your file, go back to the file option, click there and click on the wizards. Let us now look for facts. Click on facts. Again, a box opens which shows whether you want it to be a business fax or a personal fax. So you can select the type. classic facts, modern facts. There are different types which you can select. If we select personal facts, then you can decide on the page design, whether it should be like a fax or it should be any other of these choices. Click on next and select the items to be included in the fax template. For instance, you can select the type of message. So you can either type in the type of message that you are sending, or you can select one of these for your information, important information. The next options are for salutation, like to whomsoever it may concern, or dear so and so, and a complimentary clause which can be yours faithfully, regards, etc. So we have selected the type of message to be important information, to whom it may concern, with yours faithfully as the ending. Click on next. Choose a name to save the template. So we can decide now where we want to save. Click here. Create a fax form from this template or make manual changes. We have selected manual changes. Click on next and it shows you the option where you want to save it. So you can decide an address location. We have not changed it. We have used the name as was, and we have now clicked on click on open copy next to see the fax template, the fax wizard. So you can see computer Shiksha is written, the date is written, to whom it may concern, and you have place for entering your text. It ends with yours faithfully. So this is how you can prepare your fax wizard or fax template. Close this also. Let's go back to the file menu, click on wizards, and let's look for another. For instance, there is agenda, there is presentation. Click on presentation and it opens a box where it's a presentation wizard. So if you click on create, it will open a new Impress file which you can use to create a new presentation. So next, once again we close it, go to file, go to wizards, and let's look for web page. If we click on web page, you can convert your present file into a web page. Click on next and you have select the document that you want to publish. So you can click on add here, then it will show you from where you want to add. So if your file is on desktop, like we have selected class 6, click on that and that particular file opens and it will be included as a web page. There are various slides in this file. So you can close this, go to the taskbar and open your file that you were working on. Once again, let's go to file menu. Click there, click on wizards, and this time let's look at document converter option. So here you can use the document converter to convert one type of document to another type. For instance, you have Microsoft Office. So if you click on Microsoft Office, you can have Word document, convert Excel document, PowerPoint document. Click on next. We have selected PowerPoint document. So from the PowerPoint document, you can now select which document you want to import from. You have to select the path. So we have selected desktop, clicked on OK. And then where you are wanting to save this, you can select the drop-down window here. And again, you have the select path. So we select desktop and click on OK, click on next. And you can see the summary of your document. And you can close this. So this is how you can use the wizard option in your Impress file to create wizards or templates for letter, fax, also do document conversion. Let us now learn about the send option and understand what happens when we use the send option. Can you tell why do we use the send option? With the send option, you can send your impress file to another user. However, to be able to use the send option, you need to have an account on Outlook. Also, if your Windows 8 or 10 is logged in using Outlook or any other live account, then also you can send your impress file through an email without having an Outlook account. In case your Windows is not logged in with any live account, then you need to have an Outlook account. Let us now watch this video and learn how we can send our document. Let us watch this video and see how we can use the send option to send our document. So we open our document which we want to send, the impress file, and then we take our cursor to the menu bar, click on file, and then look for the send option. When you come to send, you can see there are options for sending document as mail, email, or email and open document presentation, or email as Microsoft PowerPoint presentation, or email as PDF. Let's click on document as email because we want to send this document with an email. Now you should have an Outlook account with your computer, on this computer. If you have an Outlook account, as soon as you click on send document as email, as you can see in the video, an Outlook page opens for email. And your file which you were wanting to send is already attached here. You can see attached, the file name is appearing. Now all you have to do is type in the sender, type in the receiver's email ID, the email ID of the person that you want to send this document to. We are typing as an example abcd@computershiksha.org. If you want, you can type a subject for this email that you are sending. You can also type in the text area, you can type some message. And then when you click on send, this document will be sent as email. Since we don't want to send it right now, we just close this document, this page, and click on OK here. So this is how you will send, use the send option to send your document impress file as email. You will now learn about the properties option of the file menu. Do you know what happens with the properties option? Using the properties option, you can get information about your impress file, like when was this file saved, details of the file, like how many pages does it have, how many words are there, how many paragraphs are there, what is the size of the file, etc. Within properties, there are many options like general description, security, statistics, etc. Let us watch the video and learn the use of all these options. Watch this video now to learn about the properties option. The properties option will tell you many pieces of information about your file. Click on the file in the menu bar and then click or select the properties option. As soon as you select properties, the properties of this file, the box opens. By default, we have the general tab open. First, it gives you the title of your file, which is right now, it's called Untitled 1. Then it tells you what type of document it is, open document presentation. If you have saved it, it gives you the location, gives you the size of this file, when it has been created, when it has been modified, If you had printed this file, it would also show you the printing date, etc. Then total editing time that you have taken on this. Next option is description. If you want to give a specific description for your file, you can give a title and subject and also give some comments for that. So this is to, if you want to describe your file and give it a description. Next is custom properties. If you want to customize any properties, which we are not doing right now. Next is internet. So do not refresh automatically is selected. Other options are refresh this document and redirect from this document. So if you select redirect from this document and select after say 5 seconds and you click on this box here to attach a file, you can go to the desktop and select one of the files which will get attached. So we have selected this Impress class 1 file, said OK. So you can see the link has come here. So this file will get redirected again and again after 5 seconds. Once again, let's come back to our file. Go to the file option. Once again, click on the properties option to see the other properties. The next option is, right now we have just said refresh this document. If you want to keep on refreshing this document, you can define after how many seconds you want to refresh this document. This is related to internet. The next option is for security. In security, if you want to make your document secure, you don't want anybody to do anything else but only to open it as read only, select that option and click on OK. Right now we are not doing this, we are not changing the security, so we just close this box. So this is how you can use the properties option to define properties of your file. Let us now learn about printer settings. Can you say what happens with the printer settings? Printer settings are used when you need to get a hard copy of your document by printing it on a printer. The data which is available on your computer is called a soft copy. You can use the printer in many ways on different computers. Here, you will need to connect the printer to your computer with a cable. Let us watch the video to see how we can make use of the printer. Let us watch this video to learn about the printer settings option. So in order to print a document, you need to know about your printer settings. You can go to the file menu in the menu bar, click there, and then click on the printer settings option. As soon as you click on the printer settings option, the printer settings box opens, printer setup box opens. It first gives you the name of the printer which is attached to your computer. If there are more printers attached, this drop down button will show more printers. So select the printer on which you want to print. Then there is a properties button. If you click on this, you will see different types of properties of the printer. Let's first look at the advanced properties. So here it shows you the paper output. If you want to increase the number of copies and collate them, you can define that here. You can define the type of graphics that you want. For instance, image color management or ICM. So if you want pictures, you can define those here. You can look for the options here. So image color management, you want to enable or disable. Then there are document options, which are for advanced printing features, which you can enable or disable again. Once you start using printers, you will get to know which options you need to use. Then there are printer features. Again, print all text as black, you can disable or enable that. Similarly, you want to print your documents from front to back or back to front, these options are available. Then the next tab is for printing shortcuts. So here you can select what you want to do. There are many options available. Like you want to do general everyday printing. And then within this, you can define the print quality that you want. Normal, fast normal. Next is paper type. So if you have plain paper or if you have different types of paper, you can define that. The size of the paper you can define, whether you want letter or you want legal or other options. Then next is orientation, whether you want to print it in portrait mode or landscape mode. And print on both sides, you can say off or on. Next option is for paper quality. So print, the paper size options are there. If you click on the drop down button, you can select more as the options. And here you can either see metric options or in English. So if you know the names of the documents that you want, you can select those from here. Executive, letter, legal, or bond sheet sizes. You can select envelopes, you can select. And then after selecting, you will have to click on OK. But since we are not changing, we'll just click on cancel. Then we are not going to use the real life digital photography. You can see options for print quality, normal or high quality. Next is effects. In effects, you can choose for whether you want to print default print settings or you want to have some specific print settings, whether you want it on actual size, and if you want to print the document on letter or any other options here, there are different options here, A4, A5, A6, different types or envelope. So what do you want to print this document on? And there is also a percentage of your font that you are printing. So you can either choose the fonts to appear as 100%, or if you want, you can increase the printing percentage. The size of the font would increase or decrease. Next option is for finishing. So if you want default print settings or any other options, then pages per sheet, you can define whether you want to print one sheet per page or one page per sheet or two pages per sheet, like that. You can define that. The next option is for color. So if you click there, you can see that you can print either in grayscale, which means black and white, and you can choose high quality or normal. If you don't choose the print in grayscale, color printing is chosen by default. So once you have made your changes, you will click on OK. Right now we are not changing anything, we just close this box. Other than the properties, there is also an options button, but we are not going to use it. So we just click on OK. Once we have changed the printer settings to our desired requirements, and then we can go ahead and print our impress file. So this is how you will use the printer settings to set up your printer for printing a document. Let us get to know about templates next. Do you know why templates are used? Using the template option, you can create templates which can then be used later for your work. To put it in simpler words, the template provides you access to some work that has been done previously, which you can use for your present work. You can paste the template in your document. Let us watch this video to see how a template is used. This video will now tell us about templates and how we can create, save them and use them. To create and save templates, we need to go to the file menu in the menu bar. Click there, left click on that file menu, and then click on the templates option. As soon as you click on the templates option, you see options here for organize, save, edit. So first we need to click on save because we want to first create a template. So the templates box opens and there is a space for new template. So we first type a name for a new template. We type ABCD in small letters and then we click on OK. So our template name has been saved as ABCD. Now again we go to the file menu, click on that and click on the templates. This time we select the organize option. So when we select the organize option, a box for template management opens. Since we have saved it in My Templates, we click on My Templates and you can see small ABCD is included or is already existing in My Templates. Now there is a commands option. Click on the drop down button. You have to first export the template and then you can get to use it. By mistake, we have clicked on import template. It opens a box which shows the location. Since this is not what we want to do, we will be cancelling this option or closing this box because we first have to. So once again we open the commands and now we click on export template. This box opens and you can choose the location. We have chosen desktop and we have chosen the name as ABCD for our template and we can save it. So it has got saved. We just close this box now. Now we can see where our template has been saved. Since we have saved it on desktop, we minimize this file. And you can see that your template is existing on the desktop as small ABCD. So now you can click on it and use it wherever you want to use it on your Impress file. So this way, you can save, create and use the templates on your Impress file. You will next learn about the preview in web browser. Can you tell why is the preview in web browser used? With the help of the option for preview in web browser, you can see your document as a web page. Here, the web page relates to any browser like Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Safari, etc. And you get to see your document as a web page in that browser. Let us now learn with the help of this video as to how you can use the preview in web browser. This video teaches us how we can use the preview in web browser page or option. So to use that, go to the file menu, click on that and then click on the preview in web browser option. The preview in web browser option opens your page in a browser or as an internet page. So once you have clicked that, you will see that your page will now or your file will appear. Your slides will appear in the internet as an internet page. As you can see here, this file has now appeared as an internet page in a web browser. So you can see the file title here, and you can, if you click on continue, you will see the next slide. If you want to click and see the next slide, you will again click on continue. If you want to go back to the first page, you will click on first page and you will come back to the first page. So this way, when you use preview in web browser, you can see your Impress file as an internet page, or as in it will open in the web browser. Click on the taskbar to get back to your file. Since this class now ends here, all of you close your file and properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you all learned about some more options of the file menu, like send, property, templates, printer settings, and preview in web browser. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.